Time now for a look at the latest in local sports. In sports, one day closer to the national championship game in Atlanta. The big news Thursday is that President Donald Trump and his wife Melania will be making the trip to Atlanta to watch the game. They're expected to be joined by Agriculture Secretary Sonny Perdue and U.S. Senator David Perdue. And Donald Trump will be at the game Monday night in Atlanta. Odds makers still have Bama favored by 4 in Monday night's contest. Big storyline is Georgia's freshman quarterback Jake Fromm from Warner Robins, who stepped in game one when Jacob Eason got hurt and has led Georgia to an SEC championship and a shot at a national title. Fromm was all set to sign with Alabama until Kirby Smart took the job at Georgia, got Fromm to flip from Bama to Georgia and come to Athens, something that Alabama coach Nick Saban apparently not real happy about, hasn't forgotten. Saban talked about Fromm on Wednesday, saying, quote, "We thought he was a fantastic player, very instinctive, very smart, makes great choices and decisions, always puts his team in the best play they can be in." Saban says he sees Fromm doing a lot of checks at the line of scrimmage. Saban says he demonstrates the knowledge of the game with preparation and intelligence. Saban says, "We had Fromm in our camp. We were excited to have him be part of the Alabama program." But he says he did understand that Kirby Smart was the one recruiting him to Alabama. And when Kirby took the Georgia job, we knew there was a possibility of him heading to Athens, which Fromm did, and the rest is history. And now he squares off in his freshman year against the team that he almost signed with, the Alabama Crimson Tide. Again, a big storyline of the game. Saban's 11-0 against his former mentors who have gone on to become head coaches. Kirby Smart with a chance to break that trend. But reports continue that it won't be a warm and fuzzy reunion when Kirby and Saban meet this week in Atlanta. Saban seeking yet another national championship. He currently has 5 under his belt. 4 with Bama, 1 at LSU. The 6 would tie him with the legendary Bear Bryant. Shaping up to be a great game. Again, 2 SEC teams Monday night, 8 p.m., Georgia and Alabama. Wild card NFL weekend set for Saturday and Sunday. The Falcons in action on Saturday night. Jaguars are in action at home Sunday at 1. Here's the lineup for you this weekend. Saturday begins with the 4:30 AFC game with Tennessee at Kansas City. Then Saturday night is the Atlanta Falcons taking on the Los Angeles Rams. In Los Angeles, Todd Gurley and company and the Rams having a great season. Kickoff set Saturday for 8:30. Our coverage Sunday begins on Big Dog Country FM 105.5 with the pregame show at 6 p.m. Then Sunday, Jacksonville hosting Buffalo at 1 p.m., the pregame at 12, and the game set for Everbank Field. It's a sold-out event down in Jacksonville. Again, they're selling standing room only tickets, but only a few of those are on sale. Then Sunday at 4, it's Carolina at New Orleans. The winners move on to round 2. The losers are out. Falcons looking to get back to the Super Bowl once again. And we'll have the predictions for you tomorrow here on our local sportscast. And finally in sports, don't forget tomorrow night, the first region basketball games of the season as Statesboro rolls into town. Varsity girls game gets underway at 6. The varsity boys game at 7:30. Again, first region contest here at home Friday tomorrow night at the Benny Ratliff Arena. That's going to do it for the latest in local